Guys, there is a lot of history when it comes to Nightshade. If you remember all the way back from the beta in Destiny 2, there was like two pulse rifles that stood out amongst all the weapons we use. Nurgle was one of them, which you guys have probably not heard that name in forever. I kind of shocked myself right now just saying it. But there was also another pulse rifle, Nightshade. This is a lightweight frame pulse, meaning it is 450 rounds per minute, and it is now returned to us here in year two. Upon returning, it can roll with random rolls, and of course we can now apply things like masterworks and mods to it to make it even nastier. Let's talk about Nightshade, guys, how it performed today in PvE as well as PvP, and if Nightshade is a force to be reckoned with or not. First up, let's go over the rolls on this one, and shout out to Furious Mudkip. He essentially snagged the god roll. This one comes with kill clip. Reloading after a kill grants increased damage. We'll get into damage values as well as time to kill here in just a moment. Also comes with rangefinder. Aiming this weapon increases its effective range and zoom magnification. Super beneficial here on this pulse rifle. If there's one thing that you can shoot yourself in the foot on when it comes to using pulses, is damage fall off. Now when it comes to other pulse rifles, like say for instance Bygones, or even things like Go Figure, by default they have really good range. But when it comes to these lightweight pulses, their range is pretty bad. So rangefinder is super beneficial here. Now the magazine perk of choice is steady rounds, and the scope of choice is red dot to MOA, which is actually the scope that I use on the previous Nightshade in year one. Now his also comes with a ranged masterwork, and he slapped on a targeting adjuster mod. We'll get into mods as well because I do have some recommendations there. So let's talk time to kill. First up at 25 per crits and 16 per body, this 450 round per minute pulse rifle has a time to kill of 0.87 seconds. Essentially, it's always gonna require 3 bursts. Now, the benefit of this pulse is that it's super forgiving. You can either kill someone in that optimal time to kill in 8 crits, or you can kill someone within 6 crits or 3 bodies. Regardless, it's gonna take 3 bursts. Now, with kill clip, our damage values jump up to 33 per crit and 20 per body, giving us a time to kill here of 0.53 seconds. Put that in perspective, guys, Desperado on Redrix is 0.43. But despite how good kill clip may be on this pulse rifle, that's not the focus. Because regardless of whatever time to kill we may get to, if the weapon can't win a 1v1, it's not even worth using. I'm looking at you, Redrix. Nightshade is very forgiving, but it's got a lot of competition. You've got things like Go Figure, some god roll right side of wrongs that I've seen. Bygones, which is like the flinch master. But even on the other end of the archetype, we have rapid fire pulses that are also really good. So needless to say, this Nightshade has a lot of competition. First up, the benefits of the weapon, guys. Yes, it's super forgiving. It also has the best body shot time to kill, which is what's also contributing to that forgiveness. And when we start comparing just optimal time to kills, not counting things like Rampage or Kill Clip, it's pretty much neck and neck with our other weapons. You've got 0.93 seconds for Bygones, 0.8 seconds there for something like Claws of the Wolf, and then we really dip low at 0.73 seconds there with Go Figure. So having a 0.87 second time to kill value here on Nightshade is not bad. And I found myself beating out a lot of these pulse rifles today. But I don't want to just jump up and say that this pulse rifle is the best pulse. Don't get me wrong, it's good, but it's not the best. Matter of fact, it's hard to say between all of these pulse rifles which one is the best. A God Roll Go Figure is a terrible pulse rifle in the hands of somebody that can't handle a 4-burst pulse rifle. But then it's absolutely godly in the hands of those that can't. So where Nightshade is that it still retains the ease of use of something like a Bygones, but with a slightly faster time to kill, getting closer to something like Claws of the Wolf or Horror's Lease. Now, one recommendation that I would make for this pulse. Its recoil direction by default is 56. Now, the targeting adjuster here that we have to help with target acquisition, that's nice. But I think this weapon would have greatly benefited by having a counterbalance mod. Bringing that recoil direction as close as we can to 100, keeping things as vertical as possible, your Nightshade will perform so much better for you if you put a counterbalance mod. Unfortunately, we didn't have one here today on Mudkip's account, but I highly recommend that if you're gonna main Nightshade, to use a counterbalance mod in Crucible. Now, I wanna look at the rolls real quick, and especially for people in PvE. The roll that you see in today's gameplay is honestly one of the best rolls that you can get for PvP. It's not bad for PvE, but I think I would try something different. When I look at these rolls for PvE, I think something like Rampage, Ambitious Assassin, and one of our magazine perks over here. Anything to increase that magazine size without hurting things like our reload speed. And possibly a minor spec or even a Rampage spec would be really good here. And I actually really liked it in Gambit. I definitely think there's some better options in terms of just slaying out mass amount of ads. Normally in my kinetic slots, I'm rocking a breakneck. But when you got all of these different ads that are kind of spread out everywhere and you just want to jump from target to target without actually moving yourself around the map too much, Nightshade is not a bad option. And it does leave the option for Ikalos to still be rocked in that energy slot if you don't have something like threat level. So overall, guys, I like Nightshade. I think it's returned to us in a much better form than it was before. Chattering Bone has been the only 450 round per minute pulse that we've had in the game as a year 2 version, and it's been a very good pulse as well. But Chattering Bone, if you're wanting to get this role right here, Kill Clip and Rangefinder, you cannot get that on Chattering Bone, as both of those are in the same column. Now granted though, Chattering Bone can roll with something like Arrowhead Break, which is why a counterbalance mod is not needed, whereas Nightshade can only roll with scopes, requiring us, at least here on console, to use a counterbalance mod. Either way it goes, both of these are very good 450 pulse rifles. They have a place, even amongst all the bygones that you may see or go figures. And I definitely believe that Nightshade has a place among our best pulses. Well, fellas and ladies, thank you all for coming and watching. And as always,
slap that like button like your mama told you right.